Subscribe to Feminism in India for your dose of intersectional feminist content. And make sure to hit the bell icon to get all the latest updates.
Princess, writer and spy. This is the story of an extraordinary woman whose life was marked by bravery, intelligence and resilience. Nur-un-Nissa Inayat Khan was born on January 1, 1914 in Moscow. The eldest child of famous Sufi teacher and musician Inayat Khan and the American poet Pirani Amina Begum, Noor was also a direct descendant of the 18th century ruler of Mysore, Tipu Sultan. Due to the outbreak of the First World War, Noor's family left Moscow in 1914 to move to London and eventually to France in 1920. Growing up, Noor was described as a quiet, shy and sensitive girl. She went on to study music at the Paris Conservatory and child psychology at Sorbonne. During this time, Noor was also writing poetry and children's stories. At just the age of 25, Noor published the book 20 Jataka Tales, stories that were inspired by the Jataka Tales on the life of Buddha. So how did the quiet, shy princess and writer of Indian origin become one of the most celebrated war heroines of World War II? In 1939, when the Second World War broke out, Noor joined the French Red Cross as a nurse. But shortly before France surrendered to Germany in November 1940, Khan and her family escaped to England. Although she was raised with pacifist values, Noor and her brother Vilayat decided to resist Nazi aggression. Noor soon joined the Women's Auxiliary Air Force as a wireless operator and was later recruited by Winston Churchill's Secret Force Special Operation Executive. Noor thus became the first female radio operator who was sent to Nazi-occupied France in World War II. Codenamed Madeline, Khan refused to return to Britain even after there were reports of the elite spy network being infiltrated by a Nazi spy. Her team was eventually captured by the Gestapo, but Khan continued to send intercepted radio messages back to England for a long time. Khan was eventually betrayed and arrested. She was sent to Pforzheim prison in Germany, where she was tortured by her Nazi captors. Khan's two escape attempts led her captors to deem her highly dangerous. As a result, she was sent to Dachau concentration camp. At just the age of 30, Khan was shot dead on 13 September 1944. It's said that Noor Inayat Khan's last words were Liberté, which means freedom. Noor Inayat Khan was posthumously awarded the George Cross, the highest civilian honour in the UK. She was also honoured with the Croix de Grâce with a silver star in France. Most recently, in August 2020, it was announced that Khan's Bloomsbury home in London will be marked with a blue plaque by English Heritage, which is a charity organisation that manages historic monuments, buildings and sites in the UK. Even today, Khan's legacy and story of courage lives on. In 2006, Shrabani Basu wrote a biography called Spy Princess, The Life of Noor Inayat Khan. For her to come into this world on the front line, taking on the Gestapo, showed her inner strength, her immense courage and resilience.